Hi friends, welcome back. Or if you're joining us for the first time, welcome to the channel. In today's video, we are going to take a look at the 2024 Butterick and Fall Winter Collection. I'm really excited to share with you my thoughts as well as my impressions of this collection, and also share with you a few inspirations and ideas of how you can use different patterns to create certain fashion trends. I want to go ahead and mention before we start the video that each one of these patterns can be purchased in either PDF or paper format. And so I'll just go ahead and mention that here so that we don't have to take the time out to mention that throughout the video. So let's go ahead and shop the collection and get into today's video. So we're starting off strong with the Butterick B7007. This pattern can be purchased in 8 to 16 or 14 to 22. And the description reads that we have a lined, very loose fitting, double-breasted jacket and coat that have long raglan sleeves with bias cuffs, front welt pockets, notch collar, top stitching and length variations, and view B has a back vent, and the sewing rating is for average sewist. And here is the line art. And I have to say, I am loving this coat because number one, it has raglan sleeves. And for someone like me who is in inverted triangle shape, that is a really huge deal. I feel like with raglan sleeves, I've been in the past anyway, I have been able to fit raglan sleeve garments to my bicep more so than set-in sleeves. And so I absolutely love a raglan sleeve pattern if it is constructed properly. I would rather for it to be a single-breasted coat, but I'm not mad at this pattern at all. I think it is a really great pattern. I love the crop variation as well as the long variation. And for inspiration, I have seen quite a few different designs that are similar to this out there. Many of those designs have fabrics that are featured in plaid, striped, or herringbone, or some type of houndstooth. That seems to be the trend for 2024. Personally, I would sew this in a solid color because I feel like a solid color would go with more of my wardrobe than a plaid or a striped or a houndstooth fabric. I feel like I would be very limited in what I compare those with. But with a solid color like a camel, a gray, a black, any of those colors or any type of subdued color or any of those colors that are trending, maybe a navy, those colors I feel like would go with most of what's in people's wardrobe, especially mine anyway. So I would go with a solid color, but let me share with you a few inspirations and ideas of how we can actually recreate this. So the first inspo is from Anthropology, and this is a double-breasted elbow patch coat. And so I do like this one. Again, it is featured in a plaid fabric. Personally, I would select a solid color, but I think it is a really great starting point. I really do like that one there. And then there's one from ALC. This is the Lincoln Oversized Plaid Coat. This is a wool coat with raglan sleeves featured in the color brown, teal, and tan. This is also a plaid fabric. And I do love the way that they styled this model here with the mock turtleneck and the mini plaid skirt. I think that's really cute. And then we have this beautiful wool blend check coat here that also has raglan sleeves. This is the long variation of that, and I do like that one as well. And then on toast.com, there is the Frankie Wool houndstooth raglan coat, and I love me a houndstooth fabric, but as I mentioned before, I feel like I would be very limited. I do intend on making a cropped version of a houndstooth jacket this winter, but that is going to be a specific jacket to go with specific things in my wardrobe. I would like to have a jacket that is a jacket that I can pair with pretty much everything in my wardrobe. And then lastly, there's the Scowl Studio Mason Raglan Sleeve Organic Cotton Twill Trench Coat, which is also really cute. I love that one as well. So I do like this. I feel like it would be a really great coat to sew if you are wanting to sew raglan sleeves instead of set-in sleeves for a coat. I think this would be a really great option here. Now let's look at the Butterick B7012. This is a pattern that can be purchased in sizes 8 to 16 or 18 to 26. And we have a semi-fitted line jacket that has a notch collar, shoulder pads, princess seams, and long two-piece sleeves with working bent. We have an unlined flared skirt that has gores and invisible zipper. We also have full-length pants that have front pleats, side seam pockets, front fly zipper, and a waistband with belt loops and hook and bar closures. And this is rated as average. So let's go ahead and take a look at this line art here. And there are a few ideas out here, a few fashion designs out there that we can use to create something with this pattern here. And the first is the cropped jacket by Arcus Punto. This is a black crop jacket. And I'll put a few inspirations here because it's styled in many different ways. And I really love it style with the beautiful animal print. It's a really nice, I think it's a slip dress. And I think that that's really cute paired with that slip dress. They also have paired it with a beautiful wide leg pant, which is kind of similar to this. That pair of pants is a little bit more flowy, but you definitely can recreate that style as well. I love the idea of creating this as a whole outfit, and you can pair the jacket with the skirt or the pants depending on which one you want to wear and what kind of function you're going to. I think this would be a really great outfit to create. I think this pattern is probably my favorite of the collection, and I will definitely be getting this. And I think I want to recreate that houndstooth black and white jacket with this crop jacket here. So for me, I feel like this pattern is right on time for me. I definitely want to recreate this jacket, especially with that houndstooth. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love this. I love how they paired the model with the orange blazer, the tan skirt, and the tan undershirt, as well as the boots. I think it's a really great styling. I love it. I love this. So the Butterick B7006 is very familiar to a Butterick pattern that we had in the past. I believe that one was a knit. This one, I think we're sewing with stable non-scratch fabrics. We can purchase the size 8 to 16 or 18 to 26. And the description reads that we have an off-the-shoulder dress that have a slim or full skirt, lining and invisible zipper. View A has a back slit and view B has flared skirt with gores. So this is a classic style. We see this off-the-shoulder style quite often. We see them in high fashion and you know, on the runway and things of that nature quite often. And so I've seen them on Badgley Mischka, on Neiman Marcus. We have, you know, we have them on Nordstrom. These are really classic designs. So we definitely can find styles out there to help us recreate things like this. This is very beautiful. I love this. This is absolutely stunning. A really nice pattern. Here we have the Butterick B7016, which are girls, boys, and adults jackets. We can purchase this in the small, extra small to large. So I'm guessing that's for the kids. And then extra small to extra large for the adults. We have a button front family size jacket that have a pointed collar, long sleeves, flat patch pockets, and front and back yoke. View B has a contrast at the yoke and collar and pockets. And the sewing rating is average. And here is the line art. I found quite a bit in the way of inspiration for both men, women, and then also for children. There's this gorgeous patchwork denim that I found for a ladies' jacket that I think would be absolutely stunning to recreate. So I love that for the women. And then for the men, I found this beautiful corduroy jacket and then another jacket for women that's in this tan wool, which is really fun. And for children, I found quite a bit in the way of this particular design. I found one for young kids with patchwork on it. Also, you have different pockets and things. I think this is a really nice and versatile style. So that's one of the reasons why I like it. You can sew it for women, men, children, and it's so versatile. I love it. I love this pattern. I love that you can do different patchwork designs, or you can color block and you have all these different pieces that you're putting together. I think it's really nice. The Butterick B7013 is a wardrobe pattern. Misses knit, top, skirt, and pants are featured in this pattern, and it comes in sizes extra small to 2XL. So we have a loose fitting top for view A that has a crisscross front, high-low hem, and a collar band. We have a close fitting pullover top for view B that has a turtleneck and long set in sleeves with bust darts. And for view C, we have pull on pants and skirts that have an elasticated waist, and it is rated as easy. And here is the line art. So the top out of this pattern is very similar to the Vogue V1825 pattern. So if you want to sew a top that is not cropped in the front, that Vogue pattern might be a alternative for you, and you can probably sew that and be okay with that. In way of inspiration, I've seen a few crop tops like this on Shein, as well as the Outlet Mag. They also have a crossover top. The MarbleHive.com have a brown or a taupe-ish crop knitted top. And I've seen similar styles also on Yes Style. So we have the Tory Burch rib knit black turtleneck that we can actually sew for view B. And for the top end, the skirt, we have again the Fernanda pleated skirt. And we can choose a pleated fabric to make the skirt kind of stand out against that black turtleneck. I think if you have, you add texture to it, it will help it stand out a little bit more. Or you can even get a printed fabric for your bottom and then have your solid for your top, or vice versa. So anything like that, I think, would help the pattern stand out a little bit more. So let's take a look at how the model is wearing this. So here is the crisscross top with the turtleneck and the pair of pants. I do like the gray on the black better than the browns here and the gray that they're featuring here. I think this styling is a little bit better in my opinion. Butterick B7008. We can purchase this in 6 to 14 or 16 to 24. And for this pattern, we have a very loose fitting lined bomber jacket with collar variations, drop shoulders, front zipper closure, welt pockets with flaps, and long two-piece sleeves with button cuffs. And here is the line art detail here. This is very similar to the Vogue pattern that we received a couple years ago. The only difference is for view B, we do have that collar, but we're not putting any type of rib knit fabric on the lower edge of our sleeve or the lower hem of the jacket. And so we do have that option with this. But if you do have that Vogue pattern, it's probably not worth your while to go out and purchase this pattern also. It's very similar. I think I do like the oversized style. So for inspiration, I like this oversized wool cashmere bomber jacket by Theory. So that's one of my favorite there. I also like this double cashmere bomber jacket in the color camel. And then there's this sweater jacket. I think it's called the Katie, or it's by Katie. I'm sorry. It's by Katie. And it's a sweater jacket in the color camel. And it's called the Rhea Bomber Jacket. I absolutely love that one as well. That sweater jacket is absolutely gorgeous. If I can find a sweater fabric that I can use to create a bomber jacket, it would be something like this. I absolutely love that. And here is how the model is sporting this. I think this is a really cute jacket. I like it. I do like it. I didn't find much in the way of inspiration for this, but there are a few pieces that are similar to this, and I'll share with you what they look like here. This is the Butterick B7009. We can purchase this in 8 to 16 and 18 to 26. The description reads that we have asymmetric front tunics that have round neck, invisible back zipper, and tapered or long tulip sleeves. Tapered pants have grove grain waist facings and invisible side zipper with hook and eye closure. And this is rated as average. And here is the line art. So I think this would be really nice for those of us who like looser silhouettes, especially on the top half of our body. I don't really like oversized or loose fitting tops as much, but this does look very comfortable, and I do like the way in which it is presented on the model. I'm not crazy about the color. The color looks absolutely fantastic on her skin tone, though. Absolutely love that. Next, we have the Butterick B7005 Mrs. and Petite Button Front Dress with Sleeve Variations. We can purchase this in the size 4 to 12 and 14 to 22. We have an unlined fit and flare dress that have princess seams. We have flaps, a front button closure. We also have long sleeves with elbow darts for shaping, and we have short sleeves with a cuff for detail. So this is the line art here. And this is basically a really nice take on the Carolina Herrera yellow dress that is, I think it's the 2024 fall collection. I think it's in the 2024 fall collection. And I think this is a really great take on that. I think they did a really great job of recreating that dress. So here is the image here so that you can get a side-by-side comparison of the Carolina Herrera and the Butterick version. So on the left, I'm presenting the Carolina Herrera, and here in the middle or on the right, you see the Butterick version of it. And it's almost a really great identical match here. I absolutely love how they created this design. This Carolina Herrera dress can also be purchased in the color black as well. And so I do like the black color a little bit more than this yellow color, but we can definitely recreate something like this and use whatever kind of fabric we want. Honestly, I do like the way that they styled the model. It is really nice, and I do like this dress. I think it's a cute little dress. Here we have the Butterick B7010. We can purchase this in the sizes 8 to 16 or 14 to 22. We have a semi-fitted button front shirt that have a pointed collar, neckband, satin sleeves with button cuffs and placket opening, edge stitching, and shaped hem. View A has contrast. View B front is cut on bias. So here is the shirt here. And for inspiration, I thought about this Nordstrom Mary Stripe button-up shirt. It comes in many different colors, including a similar color that you see here that's featured with the Butterick model. But that top on Nordstrom, you can get that in pink, I think green, black, blue, just all different types of colors, gray. I think that is a really great one. But I also like this Ralph Lauren striped shirt as well. It comes in the color black and white. I absolutely love this one. And if I were to create a striped version of a top, it would definitely be this Ralph Lauren variation. I think that it's very cute. And yeah, it offers for a lot of inspiration and a lot of ideas here. Now let's take a look at the Butterick B7010. This is Mrs. Shirts that can be purchased in sizes 6 to 14 or 16 to 24. We have a front button down shirt with sleeve variations, spread collar, drop shoulders, and back yoke with box pleat. View A is cropped with short sleeves, and view B has a front self tie, high low hem, and long sleeves with button cuffs. and the sewing rating is average. And here is the line art here. And for this, there are so many different variations that I thought of specifically for view B, the cropped or the tie front top there. So for inspiration, I thought about a few different top patterns here. The first is by wellheeled.com. So this is the conjunction shirt in the color white, but they also have other colors. They have it in black and I think also navy blue. So I absolutely love how they style their models there. There's also the Brave and True site. They have the Nova shirt in the color black. So I love that one as well. And I love the way in which they style their models as well. So let's go ahead and see a little bit of a side-by-side comparison here so we can get an idea of how we can recreate this Butterick top. For the crop variation, I thought about the Renata top, and there are a few others as well. So I'll just go ahead and put those up here, and you can see some inspirations on how we can create these types of looks here. Not bad. I absolutely loved this top as well. At first, I was thinking, oh no, with the tie front detail, wasn't really feeling it. But as I showed you all in the Vogue collection, we can definitely create these different looks with these tops because Vogue just released a tie front top as well. So you can create a dress, or you can put your own little take on it. You can put a little belt on the front, or, you know, just do so much with these tie front detail tops that I think it won't look so basic like this basic white. You can do so many different things with these types of styles. And lastly, let's take a look at the Butterick B7014, which are Mrs. and Women's Lounge Dress and Top and Pants. We can purchase this in extra small to extra large and 1X to 5X. So that's really impressive for Butterick for them to go up to a 5X. This is a semi-fitted dress and top that have long sleeves with sleeve bands, cowl neckline, adjustable drawstring, and hem band. Top has side openings, pull-on pants with elastic waistband, front pockets, and leg bands as well. This is rated as easy, and here is the line art for the dress. And here is the line art for the top and the pants. Now for the dress, I am finding that this is actually a trend. Like people are, this is trending. This style is trending. So you can see it on Nordstrom, on Neiman Marcus, on variations of it, on Neiman Marcus or Saks Fifth. You can even see versions of this on different sites like Macy's and Dream & Co. Like, This is actually a trend. I didn't think that this would, you know, be a trend, but I'll go ahead and put some inspirations here so you can see what these different looks look like. So sites like Macy's, Nordstrom, and Catherine's, they are actually trending like the knitted versions of these, but the more high fashion designer sites, you'll see that they are trending this type of style and more elegant type fabrics. So let's go ahead and let's look at how the model is sporting this. So this style specifically is trending on those different sites that I mentioned. Not so much this here, but this style here is trending quite hard on those sites that I have mentioned. So those are my thoughts of the Fall and Winter Butterick collection of 2024. Let me know what you thought in the comment section below of this collection. I don't think it's a bad collection. I do feel like we can take a lot of these different pieces and recreate them using those inspirations that I have showed throughout this video of the different, you know, the fashion and the styles that are trending. I do like a few of these pieces. My favorite is the cropped blazer. I definitely want to recreate something with that cropped blazer and maybe even the skirt and the shirt out of that as well. So that's what I have for today's video. Again, let me know what you thought in the comment section below. I love to hear from you, and I will talk to you all in the next video. Bye.